The old right conservative constitutional position has been that we should avoid war. We should be willing to talk to our enemies and be friends with people and trade with people. And we should remember that there is a Christian just war theory that is very, very important and something that I adhere to, that you just don't go to war as a first resort against people who haven't attacked us. This just does not fit my personal philosophy, and it rejects the whole concept of the Constitution. One of the major reasons we fought the revolution and had a constitution was to take that power away from the executive branch. And yet we've just, and the Congress reneges and they just deliver it to the president on a platter and say, do what you want. And not only have we done that, this last go around, the power is delivered to the president and said, well, yes, we think you need this power, because we believe that you need this to find out where all those weapons were, and because of 9/11, which was absolutely false. And then the number two reason that they gave was, we want to make sure you enforce UN resolutions. We shouldn't be going to war for UN resolutions ever. My position has been, and some of you may have heard, I don't think the UN serves our interests at all. I'd just as soon be out of the UN if we had our way. But all these issues are interconnected. I think we see our problems. I see that the freedom philosophy brings people together. The Constitution brings us together. Welfareism and excessive spending and deficits and socialism divides us, because everybody has to go to Washington. Those who have the biggest clout, those who are the biggest, best lobbyists, those are the ones who go and they grab. And then whether it's the medical industrial complex or the banking industry, or whether it's the military industrial complex, that's who ends up controlling our government. That's who has control of our government today. And we have to get it back. And just believing in the Constitution, we don't have to do anything brand new or different. Yes, this campaign is revolutionary, but it really is the continuation of a revolution that occurred a couple hundred years ago. And we want to expand on it. We want to improve it. We want to go forward. We don't want to go back to anything. But there was a good start, and it's a new idea. Freedom is a new idea. Tyranny is the ancient idea. And now we are drifting so much closer to tyranny, in the acceptance that government will control us and the government becomes our parents and runs roughshod. And we cannot lose the confidence that freedom really works. And if we want prosperity, we want freedom, and we want marketplaces. And for so long, conservatives and constitutionalists have lost the argument, they've lost the moral high ground, because those who want to give things away, I'm not talking about where they steal it from, but they want to give things and take care of people, they get the moral high ground, and they come by as being compassionate. And we who believe in liberty, we lack compassion. But the truth is, there's only one compassionate system known to man, and that is freedom and personal responsibility. Then there's enough wealth, and then we will all have personal responsibility to use that compassion that we have first to take care of our families and friends and neighbors, and there would be so much wealth that we could spread this wealth around the world. Instead of trying to spread this message through armed might and bombs and weapons, this weapon would be... message would send such a strong message that those others in around the world would come and want to emulate us, and that's the way it should be. We should never have to use force. Thank you very much.
I'm not running for president because of things I want to do. I'm running because of things I don't want to do. I don't want to run your life. I don't want to run the economy, and I don't run the world. The issues are very important, and right now that's sort of paying off, because people now are digging out speeches I gave 20 years ago. And, my goodness, you said the same thing 20 years ago.
Some of the strongest supporters of the war declare that we are a Christian nation, yet use their religious beliefs to justify the war. They claim it is our Christian duty to remake the Middle East and attack the Muslim infidels. Evidently, I have been reading from a different Bible. I remember something about blessed are the peacemakers. My beliefs aside, Christian teaching of nearly 1,000 years reinforces the concept of the just war theory.
This Christian theory emphasizes six criteria needed to justify Christian participation in war. Briefly, the 6 points are as follows. War should be fought only in self-defense. War should be undertaken only as a last resort. A decision to enter war should be made only by a legitimate authority. All military responses must be proportional to the threat. There must be a reasonable chance of success, and a public declaration notifying all parties concerned is required. The war in Iraq fails to meet almost all of these requirements.
And the most important thing is that I'm pro-freedom and pro-constitution.
I love you. Nice to meet everybody.
We're interested to know, tell us about your personal faith and what it means to your life.
I get to my God through Christ. Christ to me is a man of peace. He is for peace. He's not for war. He doesn't justify preemptive declared war. I strongly believe that there is a Christian doctrine of just war, and I believe this nation has drifted from that. No matter what the rationales are, we have drifted from that, and it's very, very dangerous, and I see in many ways being unchristian. And to justify what we do in the name of Christianity, I think is very dangerous and not part of what Christianity is all about. Christ came here for spiritual reasons, not secular war and boundaries and geography. And yet we are now dedicating so much of our aggressive activity in the name of God. But God, He is the Prince of Peace. That is what I see from my God, and through Christ, I vote for peace.
We have a lot of goodness in this country, and we should promote it, but never through the barrel of a gun. We should do it by setting good standards, motivating people, and have them want to emulate us. But you can't enforce our goodness like the neocons preach with an armed force. It doesn't work.